Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, all of participants and especially all of presenters. Welcome to International Conference on Agriculture and Applied Science. I'm glad to see you, although in virtual conference only. For starting in this conference, let us say basmalah together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala who give us guidance, happiness, and healthy. So we are able to join and participate in this conference. Secondly, salawat and salam never forget we send to Prophet Muhammad who has bring us from darkness to brightness. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce myself. My name is Dwi Desmiani Putri. I will be serving as your moderator. And here, I help by Mr. April as person in charge in this room meeting. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, before we start the presentation, I would like to inform you about guidelines or rules of the game in this conference. The guidelines of this conference, the first one is the official language of ICOAS is English. So our presentation should be delivered in English, including Q&A, question and answer. The second rule, in the plenary session, presenter will presentation with the pre-recorded video. In this room, at Animal Science and Fisheries Scope, we collected 14 presentation video, which divided into 3 presentation sessions, and each session consists of 4 until 5 presentation video. And after playing sequel presentation video, we'll continue to question and answer stage. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, presenter and our participants, I hope the information is clear enough, right? Okay, for all presenter and participants, for time efficiency reasons, let's restart the presentation session. In the first session, we are going to play 5 presentation video. Okay, in the first question, the first video with title Carotenoid Derivate Compound Originating from Terasi Udang and Indonesian Steam Phase will be presented by Mr. Mahrus Ali. The second video with title Change of Physical of Broiler Meat Give Steam Test Type extract in drinking water during room temperature storage will present by Miss Suraya Sakti Syahpura. Next video, with title Performance of Royal Given Dry Carrot Waste Juice as a feed supplement will present by Mr. Rico Nofiadi. Fourth video will present by Miss Admi Octaviana with title Supplementary of Coconut Pulp Extract to Feed to Increase Growth of Saline Tilapia. And the last video in this session will present by Ms. Rahmawati with title Improving the Quality of Feed Chemical Composition by Addition of Dragon Fruit Killed Meal. Okay. We want to show the video.
Good morning. Today I would like to present our research which title Carotenoid Derivative Compound originating from terasi udang and Indonesian shrimp paste. Our team consists of Vibrano Raini, Diah Kusumawardani, Nuning Mahmudanur, and me myself, Mahrus Ali. Terasi udang is the most popular shrimp paste product in Indonesia. This product daily consumed for generation as traditional condiment, and it has a distinctive aroma and flavor. The production of terasi udang was quite simple through fermentation by using krill or udang rebon as primary raw material that was added by 5 until 10% of solar salt. The fermentation process employ hydrolytic enzymes during degrading the complex compound into the simpler one. So it is important to explore the derivative compound, especially carotenoid that produced during the terasi udang fermentation. Terasi udang distribute in almost island in Indonesia, including Sumatra, Java, Bali, Nusa Tenggara, Sulawesi, and Papua. Previous research is only focusing on terasi udang processing, chemical characteristic, microbial isolation, lactic acid bacteria identification, and hydrolysis enzyme isolation. So it is lack of research in identifying the derivative compound, such as amino acid, fatty acid, volatile compound, and pigment. This research aims to isolate and identify the carotenoid compound originating from terasi udang. Our research on terasi udang started from 2013, and in 2020, focusing on isolating and identifying the pigment compound, especially carotenoid, and their bioactivity study. Raw material of terasi udang come from Labuhan Maringgay, eastern region of Lampung, Indonesia, and the isolation of carotenoid by using maceration in and soaking in ethanol for 72 hours, and the identification of carotenoid by using spectrophotometer and HPLC. The total carotenoid by using spectrophotometer following by the method of Hendry and Grimm, while the carotenoid pigment identification by using HPLC Shimatsu with Simpec column and chromatogram detected by photodiode array detector. The processing of terasi udang in Labuhan Maringgay is quite simple, is almost same with all Indonesian shrimp paste. Our research also find that total carotenoid from raw material as a TFSP is 0.25 milligram per gram carotenoid, while the total carotenoid from terasi udang is 0.41 until 2.90 milligram per gram. HPLC identification of carotenoid-based compounds, we found out six type of carotenoid, including beta-carotene, echinenone, cathartoxanthin, beta-z-astaxanthin, astaxanthin, and astaxanthin. This is the chromatogram of carotenoid-based compound from terasi udang. And this is the structure of carotenoid-based compound. Six type of carotenoid from terasi udang. And we also carry out in silico analysis via KIP1 and RF2 pathway that conclude that the carotenoid compound from terasi udang is have a prospective as an antioxidative compound. So our research conclude that we have found six type of carotenoid from both acetes and shrimp paste product. And the second, the prolong of fermentation period will increase the value of the pigment. And the last, the pigment-based carotenoid has potential function, especially as an antioxidative compound. Thank you for your attention.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for the opportunity given reason the reason. Results of our research entitled Improving the Quality of Its Chemical Composition by Addition of Dragon Fruit Pale Meal. Providing high quality feed is one of the efforts to increase fish productivity and growth, as well as reduce fish mortality. One of the additional alternative feed ingredient is a source of vegetable protein is dragon fruit peel, which is a lot of was around us and has potential for feed. Indonesia is country with a dry tropical climate, which is suitable for the growth of dragon fruit trees. And the fruit is one of largest fruit export commodities. And period from January to March 220, which contribute 234%. So the purpose of the study is determine the chemical composition of it with the addition of dragon fruit meal at different dose. The method of separation and drying of dragon fruit peel in its pulp refers to Hernawati and Aryani. Average weight of fruits were 711.63, where resulting the FPM of 8.69 gram. Chemical composition of the FPM analyzed using the AOAC method at Laboratory of Agricultural Product Technology, Lampung State Polytechnic. Chemical composition like in this table, which protein content of 5.08%. The method of addition the FPM and commercial feed were a total of 500 gram of feed was mixed evenly with 2.5 gram of binder and the FPM according to the dosage of each treatment. Previously, the FPM and binder has been homogenized with distilled water. And then feed that has been treated was dried in the sun for several hours. The result show that the addition of the FPM was able to increase the protein in all of addition treatment. And in addition, 1.5% of the FPM was resulting highest increasing protein in decreasing other chemical contents. Conclusion, the addition of the FPM to feed result in an increase in chemical composition of the feed, especially the protein required for fish growth. The addition of 1.5% dragon fruit pale meal to the feed produced the highest protein. I thank Lampung State Polytechnic for funding this research. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning all.
Thanks for coming to my presentation in Infrastructure Conference of Agriculture and Applied Science 2020. Thank you. I would like to talk about this shrimp peptide excite or HPA. This is my this is our research by Sureka Visapura, Yana Sukaryana, and Susanti. In this presentation, we will discuss about change of physical of broiler meat given shrimp peptide extract in drinking water during room temperature storage postmortem. Introduction. This research is marine organism by shrimp. Its organic compound give negative impact toxic to
environment.
Imposex masculination in female and unnatural same thinking by Diana et al. 2050. And bioaccumulator in human food chain in marine organism. Colosio et al. 2011. And then introduction in shrimp peptide organism, it the glucosamine in nutritional compound. Then contain amine food group, synthesis for also nutrient function group, and adjust activity by acylating the hydrolytic functional group. And then this research is economically expensive and environmental friendly, low toxic because made from biomass. Material and method, this is a broiler and shrimp peptide extract. Then treatment, for treatment, TO 0%, treatment 1%, treatment 2%, and treatment 3%. Material and methods given in the morning for 7 consecutive day, a treatment was repeated 5 times, and its replication consists of 10 animals then were placed randomly. The dose treatment of shrimp peptide extract was carried out after the period of adaptation to maintenance for 1 week through a mixture the drinking water at 8 AM. Parameter in our research behind water holding capacity, low cooking loss, and meat tenderness. Result and description by this research. Physical quality of meat in a parameter of meat quality consists of pH value, cooking loss, water holding capacity, and meat tender meat with test. Objectively in the table this notes A, B different superscript at the same row indicates significant difference. And conclusion, this research from the result of the study, it can be concluded that the addition of shrimp peptide extract in drinking water up to a level of 3% can improve the physical quality of broiler meat, namely water holding capacity, cooking loss, and tenderness of broiler meat. Thank you. Thank you for your attention. Thanks a lot.
Enggak ada sih, Kak. Si ini.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
My name is Rico Noviadi. I am from Animal Production Technology Study Program, Department of Animal Husbandry, Lampung State Polytechnic. I am the first author in this article. The title of this article is Performance of Broilers Given Carrot with Just Milk as a Feed Supplement. Let's do the introduction. Broiler productivity optimization is achieved through the provision of nutrients in accordance with their needs. The nutrients in the feed will be digested, absorbed, and transported throughout the broiler tissue and used for basic living, production, and reproduction. Broilers need nutrients quantitatively and qualitatively at feed to support their production performance. Several secondary chemical compounds found in natural ingredients such as carotenoids found in carrots can improve protein digestibility in broilers in tropical environments. The mechanism works by providing coenzyme precursor to help the protein digestive enzyme work better. Thus, more and more proteins are utilized for the growth and development of the broiler's body. Carrot plants have several important nutrients, including beta-carotene, vitamin, and minerals. The content of beta-carotene in a carrot is a precursor to forming vitamin A, which functions as an antioxidant toward of free radicals. Utilization of fish carcass meal as a feed supplement for broiler feeds is more economical through carrot tuberose, which is a carrot that is not suitable for human consumption, characterized by blister, holes, crack, wounds, or wet spots. Most carrot tuber with poor quality are simply thrown away. If not used, they will quickly rot, causing environmental pollution. The use of carrot waste in the form of dried chest milk in boiler feed has a because it is easier to digest and absorb and in the same amount has more nutrients. Beta-carotene from carrot waste juice is a provitamin A, which can increase the formation of vitamin A, which is expected to increase the performance of broiler. The research method, a total of 96 day-old chick broiler strain of Arboarchus were used in the study. The feed ingredient consists of a mixture of yellow corn, rice bran, broiler concentrate, and carrot with juice meal. Hitchner strain Newcastle disease vaccine was used on broilers at 4 days old, while a Lasota strain was used at 28 days. Disinfectants are used for cage sanitation. The study was conducted in a completely randomized design, consisting of 4 treatment and 6 replication, each of which contained 4 broilers. The treatment applied were various level of giving carrot with just milk in the feed, 0, 1, 2, 3% carrot with just milk in the ration. Composition of treatment feed in table 1 and table 2, it is nutrition content of treatment feed. Result and discussion. The addition of carrot with juice milk to the feed had not significant effect on the consumption of broiled eggs 5 weeks. The use of carrot with juice milk as a feed supplement in feed up to level of 3% has the same effect on broiler feed consumption. Active substances contained in carrot such as a beta-carotene do not affect the consumption of broiler. Broiler consumption is influenced by various factors including environmental temperature, health, immunity from off-feed, nutritional balance, body size, growth rate, and most importantly, the level of energy in the feed. And the effect of treatment for the second parameter, the additional of carrot wastes meal to the feed had a significant effect on the weight gain of broiler eggs 5 weeks. The use of carrot wastes meal in the feed causes a difference in body weight gain between treatments. This is because carrot waste contains several nutrients related to broiler growth, such as an antioxidant in the form of beta-carotene, which is a source of vitamin A. The provitamin in the form of beta-carotene in carrot contributes to increasing the content of vitamin A in the broiler's body. The higher the beta-carotene in the feed, the higher the provitamin A is converted into vitamin A. According to Sahin et al. 2009, vitamin A in carrots function 4 is able to increase feed efficiency and increase body weight. And the effect of treatment for the third parameter, the additional of carrot wastes meal to the feed had a significant effect on the conversion of broiler. The feed has a different effect on the conversion of cows. The ferret feed conversion of its treatment has the same value but result in different weight gain. The feed conversion is the value obtained by calculating the amount of feed consumption in a certain period divided by the gain in body weight of cents. The beta-carotene content in dry carrot wastes serve as a precursor for vitamin A, which will be formed into vitamin A in the broiler body. That vitamin A function in the epithelial and digestive tissue. Vitamin A is also responsible for the prolifit of intestinal mucosa cell, resulting in improved absorption of nutrients in the intestine. The more nutrients that are digested and utilized in the body of the poultry to be used for the formation of a body weight of poultry like broiler. Based on the research, we conclusion that the use of carrot wastes meal as much as 2% in the ration resulted in the best broiler performance. And we say to thank you to Langkawi State Polytechnic for financial support through DIVA 2020 fund. Oke, okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I want to introduce myself. My name is Adam Tanmene. I'm here to represent my team to present our research with the title Is supplementary of coconut pulp extract to increase growth of saline tilapia or Acromion stenoticus. This is the this study. We are from Lampung State Polytechnic. The introduction of this study, based on increasing production of tilapia every year, may formal look for various ways to achieve the success of this farming. Effect that can be done are to increase the productivity of of tilapia aquaculture to intensive culture. But intensive culture has a problem with growth. We need a way to optimize the growth. One alternative is to use prebiotic. Coconut pulp are one of the agricultural waste that have the potential as animal feed. Several studies have shown that the coconut pulp contains galactose ruminant which function as a prey beauty. The aim of this study is to increase growth and survival rate on saline tilapia that given coconut pulp extract on feed. The priority of the study is to provide information on the utilization of coconut pulp extract as prebiotic source. Material and methods of the study. The study began with coconut pulp preparation and ending with data analysis. Experimental design. This study was conducted for 7 weeks in the aquaculture laboratory Lampung State Polytechnic. The experimental used nil tilapia Oreochromis niloticus with size 5 to 8 centimeters, which were obtained from Polyfish Farm, Lampung State Polytechnic. Prior to this study, nil tilapia were acclimatized with salinity condition step by step for 14 days. After that, randomly distributed three experimental group. Each group with three replication. Its replication contain 15 fish with fish density or 50 fish per meter square. During the study, there is no replacement or addition the water of media. However, water quality checks are still being carried out. This is the step of coconut preparation according Presetio and Winarty 2019. The treatment of the study. A treatment is the control group contained without supplementary of coconut pulp extract. B treatment is 1% supplementary of coconut pulp extract. C treatment is 2% supplementary of coconut extract. The result of the study, there are no significantly different between the parameters, daily growth rate and survival rate. We are presumed due to the absence of replacing and adding water during the study. This caused a build of feces and organic material on the media. And also the salinity of the media reached about 30 ppt at the end of the treatment. Salinity is an environmental parameter that affects the biological process of an organism and will directly affect to growth. This is the conclusion of the study that the supplementary of coconut pulp extract demonstrate the high result for growth performance with daily growth rate of 1.28% and survival rate of 80%. Thanks.
Okay. Well, we have listened and watched the first presentation video, and now we continue to discussion session. The session open for three questions. And prisoner, please raise your hand, mention your name, and mention for whom the question addressed. Please, any question?
Yes, I have one question.
Okay. Please, Ms. Rahma.
Okay, thank you for moderator. I want to ask Mr. Ali, I interest your research And I want to ask about, is there any possibility that the carotenoids that were fermented for a longer time, like 10 weeks and so on, have increase or decrease the carotenoids? Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Ali. We hear the Mr. Rahman question. Mr. Ali, you still join in this room?
Hear my voice?
Okay.
Okay.
Hey, Bula.
Thank you, Mr. Rahmawati, for your kind question. Okay, I would like to answer. In my conclusion, I conclude that the second conclusion is if you prolong the fermentation period of Tarascurium acidulis, it will increase the carotenoid compound, not only total carotenoid but also all type of carotenoid, such astaxanthin, astaxanthin, and other. So if we prolong the fermentation period, it will be increased, the carotenoid compound. This is also for the next our research. After I use with DPPH in order to perform with antioxidative compound from the carotenoid, the IC50 of prolonged fermentation is higher, also higher. This research I performed with 2 weeks, 4 weeks, and 6 weeks fermentation of period. I think that's all.
Okay. Ms. Rahma.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Ali. Okay,
you're welcome.
Thank you, Ms. Ali. For a participant, any question? Okay. If no question from audience, I have a question. Actually, I have a question for all of presenter, except Mr. Ali. I just want to know, based on your research result, what is that you want to do for next research that's related with related with your research result now? Maybe Ms. Suraya can explain us what the next research that you want to do. Ms. Suraya is still joined in this room? Or Ms. Adni? Ms. Adni? Or Ms. Rahmawati, can you describe about your next project?
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Dwi Desmi. I want to continue our research. We want to apply the best result and fit, especially to commercial and economically fish, like that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for your answer.
You're welcome.
Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, after we show the first presentation video, we enter the second presentation video. This video consists of five presentation video. First video from Mr. Teguh Karyono with title Coffee Skin Waste Fermentation with Addition of Banana Sucker Microorganism Activator for Physical Quality of Ruminantia Feed. The second from Yuda Laksono with title Evaluation of Physical Quality of Alang-Alang Fermentation as Feed Green Swamp Buffalo. And third video from Ms. Dian Febriani with title Prevalence of Parasite of Disease on Juvenile Hovens Carp with Different Stocking Densities. And the next video from Ms. Suraya Kahfi Syahpura. This is the second video from Ms. Suraya with title Quality Characteristic Carcass of New Zealand White Crossbred as Given Post from Ambon Banana Skin Isolation. And the last video in this session comes from Ms. Richie with title Growth Performance of Nine Tilapia Feed on Pellet Meal Based Diet Fortification by Protein Hydrolysis of Maggot. Please show the video.
Morning. It's myself. My name is Teguh Karyono. I am from the Animal Husbandry Study Program, Faculty of Agriculture Musirawas University. I would like to talk about coffee whose fermentation with addition of banana sugar microorganism activator for physical quality of ruminants feed. First, coffee hulls are one of the agricultural waste that have been underutilized and just waste in coffee mills. Epitope they call potentially become animal feed. The optimal use of economically acceptable animal feed sources by utilizing local resources. Expensively, coffee are viable in the local environment is used as an alternative feed using the fermentation method. Then material and method. Place and time. The research was conducted in the Nutrition and Animal Feed Laboratory of the Animal Husbandry Study Program, Faculty of Agriculture, Musirawas University. Implementation was carried out from May to July 2020. Then, material and thoughts. The research used the method experimentally with a completely random design consisting of 6 treatment F1, 1 kg coffee hull plus 10 ml more banana sugar. F2, 1 kg coffee hull plus 15 ml banana more banana sugar. F4, 1 kg coffee hull plus 25 ml banana sugar more. F5, 1 kg coffee hull plus 30 milliliter banana sugar mole. F6, 1 kg coffee hull plus 35 milliliter banana sugar mole. Each treatment was repeated 4 times so that we get 24 experimental units. Second step, physical test. The observed physical test consists of degree of acidity that have been determined by Castellani procedure. Ratio and distribution. Degree of acidity or pH. The analysis also showed that the fermentation of coffee wool with banana sugar malt has no significant effect on the pH of coffee wool fermentation. Smart. The analysis of variant and tabulation data in the study of silage that the aroma, color, the result of the analysis of variant sound, the fermentation of coffee wool silage with banana sugar malt as ruminant animal feed that no significant effect on the silage color with the experimental texture. The analysis of variant and tabulation data on the fermentation of coffee wool silage with the banana sugar malt microorganism local so no significant effect on the texture of coffee wool silage fermentation. In conclusion, the result of the research of fermentation of coffee wool waste with the addition of banana wheel malt activator on physical quality for ruminant animal feed, it can be concluded the addition of banana wheel malt activator in fermentation of coffee wool the best aroma result in the effort treatment 3.29 and give equally good result on physical properties such as degree of acidity, pH, color, and texture of the fermented coffee wool. Thank you for your attention.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Is my English not perfect. My presentasi evaluasi of physical quality alang-alang impratas fermentasi aspid grain swab buffalo. The name Laksono Inwasir Ibrahim, program studi peternakan Fakultas Pertanian Universitas Musirawas. Forget is one of the success of life for ruminansia. The can be seen from the net for feed from ruminansia. Almost extinct patient consistent of fresh forget to meet the basic need of life grow and development of livestock consumption forget be it grass or legume. Material and method, the research has been contribution in the laboratory of the Fakultas of Agriculture Musirawas, Universitas Musirawas, Lubuk Linggau, the Timur Filek, Son Sumatra, the action to plan from May and July. Matter and method. So the material used the student area that have not entered the flowing field bar molasses from agriculture store, banana have molasses water, while the tall used are copper unit, vacuum mechanics, scales oven plastic, measuring cup, pH meter, and stationery. The scan with constant UC in the resin use experimental method with a completed random design atau shared the consistent of non-parameter with R with response 3 team. The 10 factor you follow L1 2 million banana mol mol L2 2 5 milli banana wheel mol LC 3 banana wheel mol L4 2 3 5
the banana mineral L5 for the banana mineral L6 for 6 of banana mineral. Slow the special the upfront imprata significa fermentation has every significant effect. One the pH meter significant effect to one color to treatment. No significant effect the one the aroma and texture observation parameter. Consolation based one the lesson of the discussion of the study in it can be called the that the client test of Premin Imperata Sinica which was fermentation give a good volume for L4 treatment mainly C5 mol. Thank you very much.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Here I will present the result of a study entitled prevalence of parasite and disease on juvenile hoppen carp Leptobarbus hoppeni with different stocking density. Introduction. Efforts are being made in order to develop and preserve hoppen carp that with the addition of information about the health of that fish. This study aims to identify the types of parasites and disease on juvenile hoppen carp, Leptobarbus hoppeni, with optimal stocking density. Material and methods. The experimental design was a completely random design with three replication. Treatment of fish seed stocking density hoppen carp consists of three levels: 100 individuals per cubic meter, 300 individuals per cubic meter, and 500 individuals per cubic meter. The parameters observed were parasite prevalence, survival rate, and water quality. The result showed that three were six types of parasite found: Trichodina, Ichthyophthirus multifilis, Dactylogyrus, Gyrodactylus, Lernaea, and Acanthocephala. The prevalence of parasite that infected hoppen carp gave significantly different effect in each treatment. The prevalence value in each treatment is treatment A of 23.33%, treatment B of 36.33%, and treatment C of 16.33%. The higher the stocking density of the fish, the higher the prevalence of parasite agent of the carp. The survival rate in this study showed that were not significantly different between the treatment. The survival rate value obtained were from the highest to the lowest. 93%, 93.33%, and 82.4%. The water quality in this reserve is in good condition for aquaculture. Conclusion. The conclusion of this study is the type of parasite that infects Hoven carp, 3 or 6 type of Trichodina, Ichthyopyrus multifilis, Dactylogyrus, Gyrodactylus, Lorea, and Acanthocephala. The highest survival rate was in the experiment A, that is of 93%. Okay, that's the presentation for me. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for coming to my present in the International Conference on Agriculture and Applied Science 2020. I am glad to see you all. Let me introduce myself and my partner. I am Ms. Soraya Kafi and my partner is Zulfahmi and Anjar Sofiana. We are from Polytechnic of State Lampung, Indonesia, and this presenter we will discuss about quality characteristic carcass of the New Zealand white crossbreed as given first fructooligosaccharide from Ambon banana skin isolation. And then fructooligosaccharide is an alternative solution to control colibacillosis which has the ability to eliminate pathogenic bacteria in the contamination track and stimulate the immune system or immunostimulant. The fructan contain in force produced by hydrolysis of Chemory plant include has been widely reported, but the products of FOS from banana field has not been widely given FOS from banana field. And then this is material and method. This research is extraction and isolation, TLC and HPLC, then presentation FOS, and then identification FOS characteristic fructooligosaccharida from banana peel. Extraction FOS from banana peel then granted patent IDP number IDP 00063596. And then this is treatment of my research and parameter. This research is cut weights, carcass weights, percentage of carcass and bone weights. Result and discussion. Cutting weights, carcass weights, bone weights in the study were significantly different at the 5 level and very significantly different from the carcass percentage at the 1 level as shown in the table 1. And then ABCD values followed by unique letters in the column indicate significantly different. And the long trend test for using FOS using orthogonal polynomial is known that the treatment has a significant effect following the equines linear as shown in the figure 1. And then rabbit that consume more feed have a tendency to accumulate more protein in response to growth and increase in carcass weight. Carcass and carcass percentage are highly dependent on breed, environment, life weight, and nutrient in feed. The percentage of carcass has a positive relationship. And then conclusion, Ambon banana peel contains fructose oligosaccharides, which has a strong potential as a prebiotic, as evidenced by its ability to improve rabbit production performance by increased carcass quality, namely slaughter weight, carcass weight, carcass percentage, but doesn't have an effect on bone weight of the New Zealand crossbred rabbit. And then, thank you for your attention. Thank you.
My name is Richard Bukau. My article is Growth Performance of Nile Tilapia Fit on Pellet Meal Based Diet Fortification by Protein Hydrolysis of Maggot. Increased aquaculture production automatically increase the need for fish feed. On the other hand, fish meal is one of the important protein source in feed formulation. It experienced considerable obstacle in the supply because most of it was still imported. This condition caused the price of commercial feed to be expensive. One of type of material that has the potential to be developed as the substitute or the same time used as a feed ingredient is maggot. Maggot is the insect larva of black soldier fly, are known as decomposer. The process to produce the maggot is known as the bioconversion. Maggot can be used as alternative feed for various stages in fish development, from seeds to the enlargement stage and also to the brood stock. The hydrolyzed protein from fish or maggot is produced from the process of breaking down fish maggot protein into simple peptides or amino acid through. The purpose of this study was to determine the nutritional characteristics of maggot protein hydrolyzed and its effects on the growth performance of tilapia. The production of protein hydrolyzed using the enzyme hydrolysis method refers to Utomo et al. 2014. The addition of the papain enzyme with a concentration of 2, 4, 6, and 8% for 5 hours at a temperature 45 derajat Celsius. For the hydrolyzed fortification process into feed, the process of spraying liquid on the feed was carried out with different doses, 10%, 2%, 30%, and 40%. The result of this study is I have a nutrition characteristic of hydrolyzed protein maggot. The using of different doses of papain enzyme effect on the change nutritional value increases. The protein content reaches 37.9%, while the nutritional value of fresh tilapia is 80 to 90%. Fat, fiber, and carbohydrate content decrease significantly with increasing the enzyme dose. The total amino acids, the essential amino acid produced, saw an increase with increase the enzyme dose. Fatty acid and essential essential fatty acid also increase. The growth performance of Nile tilapia, the feed for tilapia with various dose 10%, 20%, 30% and 40%. Rearing a tilapia for a few weeks show the effect of adding hydrolysat on the growth length and weight of tilapia is increased. And the efficiency of the feed based on the resulting FCR value, it shows an increase in the efficiency of artificial feed for 5 weeks of keeping tilapia in the aquarium, where the greater the percentage of hydrolysat, the smaller the FCR value, so the feed was efficient. The conclusion of this study was the characteristic of the nutritional properties of the hydrolysat of maggot ingredient show an increase in protein content and a decrease for fat, fiber, carbohydrate with an increase in dose of enzyme papain. Meanwhile, the growth performance of tilapia and feed efficiency was increased by fortification of maggot protein hydrolysat through artificial feed. This is my presentation and thank you very much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have watched the second presentation video and we continue to discussion session. Any questions for this session? Fanny Agustuwarni, are you right hand?
Okay.
Fanny?
Ini moderator. Moderator.
Yes. Yeah. Any question?
Yes. I am moderator.
Yes, yes. Miss Richa, yeah. Please.
Thank please. You very much. Thank you, moderator. I want to ask to Mrs. Dian article. I want to. Yeah. I want to know. If you have early information or problem about the parasite of your fish test, what the information, early information, because before you do the study. And the second question, I haven't seen what the correlation between the density and parasite. It's a kind of parasite of the sum of parasite you have. That's all. Thank you, moderator.
Okay, thank you. Teacher, please. Is Dian Febriani answer the question? Yeah, okay. Rahmadi Aziz, please answer the question from Ms. Richard.
Okay, thank you for the question. The early the parasite of infect a hoffman cough in the organs, skin, pain, gill, and gut. That's a parasite are Trichodina, Lornea, Ichthyovirus, Dactylovirus, and Anchatocephala. And the correlation about stocking density. The increase the stocking density to increase parasite infect the parasite to hoffman cough. That's the prevalence the increase stocking density, the higher parasite to infect hoffman cough. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay. How about the answer, Ms. Rita? It's enough?
Okay, it's enough. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions for participants? If you have a question, you can write in the chat menu. Okay. If no question from audience, I have some question for all of presenter in the session presentation. Ms. Richa, Mr. Teguh, Mr. Judo, kemudian Mr. Suraya Kafi, I have the same question. Based on of your research study, may we know what is the next research that you want to do to improve your research study? Please, maybe Ms. Richa? Ms. Richa?
Yeah, thank you. My plan study, this study, should be make a hydrolyzed protein of maggot in a dry powder. But okay. I can do this study because there no one alat in Malaysia. So I still plan to get a hydrolyzed protein maggot with dry powder. To have the dry powder, we need freeze drying. So we can use this product for one of material for composition feed for fish. Thank you, that's all.
Okay. The good planning. For other presenters, is Suraya Kafi?
Thank you, moderator. This is Dwi Desmiani. Sorry, not Mr. not Mr. Miss Dwi Desmi. Not from is this my research. This is to research yang dimaksud about apa shrimp peptide extract. Then I want this research to quality carcass quality carcass for ke quality terhadap warna apa color quality in carcass. Then research one about one change physical lagi saking banyaknya ini quality carcass of New Zealand white as given forth fructooligosaccharide from Ambon banana skin isolation. My research is akan ke depannya
for next.
Next research is patent granted haki mengenai kertas kertas gitu ya. And my research next time ke ininya apa mau melihat apa sih namanya pengaruh effect of first structural oligosaccharide from Ambon banana skin isolation in given apa crossbreed New Zealand white terhadap ininya kan terhadap impact short chain fatty acid in colon New Zealand white terhadap impact to kanker colon.
Yes. You will try to implement it your research result to implement it in human maybe.
Yes, the human using crossbreed ini crossbreed New Zealand white is the same human utility.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Answer. Okay, next, Mr. Teguh and Mr. Judo.
Susah kalau nggak konsen.
Join in this room. Mr. Teguh, Mr. Judo. Can you share with us about your next project or next research that you want to do based on your research results? No comment from Mr. Teguh and Mr. Yudo? Satu lagi. Okay, untuk for Mr. Aziz, want to share with us about next research, maybe?
Okay.
Okay, maybe have a trouble with a signal. Mr. Aziz, okay. We have finished the second presentation session, and now we continue to third presentation session. In the third presentation session, only two presenters left. They are Ms. Nur Indarianti with title "The Evaluation of Commercial Fermented Feed by Saccharomyces cerevisiae of the Growth Performance of White
Any Pig." Question. Main juga peserta nih?
Iya. And the other Mr. Wasir Ibrahim. with title combination pineapple field meal and medicinal wheat in the ration of broiler chicken performance. Okay, so we will play the video.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks before and sorry. No, I can speak English well fine, but yes, I can speak English a little. This is Wasir Ibrahim, Department of Animal Husbandry, Faculty of Agriculture, University of Musirawas. This is my research. I will present the detail combination pineapple field meal and medicinal wheat in the ration on broiler chicken performance. The experiment was designed to complete randomism design or CRD with 5 treatment and 5 replicates. Treatment consisted of 0% of fermentation pineapple field meal in the ration containing 0% medicinal wheat positive control. P1, 0% fermentation field meal in the ration containing 2% medicinal wheat negative control. P2, 7.5% fermentation pineapple field meal in the ration containing 2% medicinal wheat. P3, 15% fermentation pineapple field meal in the ration containing 2% medicinal wheat. P4, 22.5% fermentation pineapple field meal in the ration containing 2% medicinal wheat. Material, this is my reset, 200 two-day male broiler chicken, commercial ration BR1 and BR2, corn, foliage, fish, and soybean meal. Feed additive was field grass, sidaguri, goat grass, patikan kebu. The treatment ration were composition of isoenergy and isoprotein. The parameter the is my reset where feed consumption, apparent dairy weight again, feed conversion ratio, and mortality. The observation data were analysis by Statistic Product and Service Solution or SPSS 16 and Duncan's multi-range test significant effect among treatment. Rasa and discussion, effect of treatment on feed consumption, analysis of variance show that death risk on the use fermentation pineapple pyrimid and yogurt ration had very significant. Effect of treatment in weight gain, analysis of variance show that the use of fermentation pineapple pyrimid and yogurt had very significant effect on body weight. Effect of treatment and feed conversion ratio, analysis of variance show that use of yogurt fermentation with pineapple mean it's a significant effect on ration conversion. Effect of the treatment mortality, this is reset, not mortality. Result showed that broiler chicken's performance did not influence the fermentation pineapple field up to 15 which order medicinal wheat. Thank you for attention.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nur Indaryanti, and my presentation today is about the evolution of commercial fermented wheat by Saccharomyces cerevisiae on the growth performance of white strain. My presentation will be divided into 4 parts. They are introduction, material and methods, result and discussion, and conclusion. The faname is one of the leading aquaculture commodities in Indonesia and is the main support for export of fishery products. Indonesia is ranked fourth as the largest shrimp producer in the world. Intensification of shrimp culture results in dependence on artificial feed. The price of feed is expensive because the main protein sources is fish meal. Substitution of fish meal with protein sources from plant-based ingredient result in changed nutrient profile, decreased palatability, low feed efficiency, and so good performance. to increase feed efficiency feed fermentation with microorganisms. Fermentasi is process for increase feed utilization, reduce fiber content, increase crude protein and fat content, vitamin availability and increase protein solubility, and amino acid patterns and increase feed material palatability, increases the digestibility of organic matter, nitrogen, amino acid, fiber and calcium. Saccharomyces cerevisiae produce enzyme amylase, protease, glucosidase, glucoamylase, citinase, fosfolipase, and catalase. There are three research objectives, including number one, evaluating the feed fermentation process with Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Number two, assessing the ability of Saccharomyces cerevisiae in increasing protein. Number three, evaluating fermented feed on crude performance and feed efficiency. The first try is commercial feed fermentation with Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Digestibility test. The experiment used egg fish tank filled with seawater with salinity of 25-28 ppt. Shrimp used come from Kalianda, South Lampung. Vanamis shrimp were kept in a stocking density 15 individual fish tank. Test feed 5 times a day. Shrimp growth test. The experiment used egg round ponds with a size of 1 meter and filled with seawater with a salinity of 25-28 ppt. Vanamis shrimp are kept for 60 days with a stocking density of 100 individual ponds. Test feed is given 5 times a day. Result and discussion. The picture show that the fermentation process causes decrease in crude feed fiber. Crude fiber content in feed decreased due to digestion of crude fiber by Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The increase in protein is caused by the presence of protein synthesis by yeast because yeast itself contains nucleic acid which can contribute to nitrogen, which is a source of single cell protein. The growth of Saccharomyces cerevisiae will increase the microbial mass and will increase the protein content of the feed. The secretion of Saccharomyces cerevisiae extracellular enzymes also plays a role in increasing protein content. Increasing the value of protein and phosphorus digestibility indicate that more protein and phosphorus can be absorbed by shrimp. Digestibility of fermented feed is better than non-fermented feed. This is because the yeast fermentation process breaks down complex components into simpler substance so that they are easier to digest. Fermented feed is easier to digest than unfermented feed, so shrimp do not need more energy to digest it, so that excess energy can be used for growth. Shrimp which were given fermented feed show better growth performance and feed utilization efficiency. In addition, the FCR value of fermented feed is also better than that of non-fermented feed. The nutritional content of fermented feed leads to a much more efficiency utilization. The addition of Saccharomyces cerevisiae and feed can improve protein digestibility, increase feed efficiency, increase growth, and increase and decrease FCR. Conclusion. Based on the result of the study, it can be concluded that the Saccharomyces dose of 6% gave the best result in improving nutritional quality and feed digestibility, thereby increasing the growth performance of vanamis shrimp. Deep appreciation and gratitude are conveyed to UPTM and Lampung State Polytechnic who have funded this research. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we continue to the discussion Q&A session. Please, for audience, participants, indication.
Okay. Okay, moderator. My question to Mrs. Nur Indaryanti, what the reason why you use Saccharomyces to change or improve the quality of feed every fungi or ragi or another have a special nutrition, special parameter nutrition, like special for fiber to increase the protein, like that. Yeah, just that my question for Mrs. Nur Indaryanti. Thank you.
Mrs. Nur Indaryanti, answer the question.
Yeah. Thank you for the question. Saccharomyces cerevisiae increase protein and decrease fiber because Saccharomyces cerevisiae extracellular enzyme protease, glucose, cellulase. Saccharomyces cerevisiae most using fermentation feed stuff, bahan baku pakan. Saccharomyces cerevisiae mikroorganisme yang sering dipakai di fermentasi pakan. Using Saccharomyces cerevisiae because mostly using at tambah increasing feed commercial low protein. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Any question? Any question from the participant or presenter? In this room, I see Miss Intan Kamila. Miss Intan Kamila. If the notation, well, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of this third session, this activity has also ended. Please give big applause for all of the presenters today. Okay, thank you for our presenter for giving such informative and interesting presentation. And thank you very much to our audience for your participation. Hopefully, the information that we have shared today would be useful for all of us. before we close the meeting in this room, we would like to announce the best presenter in this room at Animal Science and Fisheries Group. Actually, it's difficult to us to choose the best presentation in this room because our presenter has achieved the best performance. But we have to choose. Okay? The best presenter in this group is Miss Rahmawati. Miss Rahmawati, who present the article with title "Improving the Quality of Its Chemical Composition by Addition of Dragon Fruit Peel Mint." Congratulations for Miss Rahma. Okay. All of presenter and all participants in this room, before we finish the conference, I apologize if I have mistake in judging presentation. For closing in this meeting, let us say hamdalah together.
Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim.
Thank you very much for your attention. See you for next last year. Next year. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.